Huh? You want me to do another video about climate change? But I thought climate change was about the world getting warmer and it's freezing outside. I mean, it's snowing like crazy. I even saw in the news that some places are even seeing record snowfalls. I mean, this is... Are you kidding? You're not cold.
Okay, okay. It's not that cold and we're inside. But really, why are some places seeing more snow despite the fact that the world is getting warmer? I mean, there are a lot of interesting questions and apparent contradictions when it comes to climate change. And that's why we're here today. Things aren't always as simple as they seem. So, again, today, I'm still Ziad Elmai. I still don't know what I'm talking about. But again, we're gonna get some real experts to ask your actual questions that you've asked on social media. This is Climate Change Support. So, first question. So if the planet is getting warmer, why is it snowing more in some places? Hashtag climate hoax.
Well, there's the obvious myth that people confuse climate change with global warming, and climate change is more than just global warming. It is a change to the entire world's climate. We see this in rainfall, we see this in temperature, we see this in storms, wind, oceans, everything. One myth is climate change is this slow-moving background problem about heat only. And instead, we need to re-understand climate change as a problem that we are experiencing very clearly as these extreme events constant.
So, let's take a closer look at that question about snow. Boom! No, not that close. We wouldn't want to offend it. Here's the thing. It's a fact that warmer air holds more moisture than colder air. More water in the air means more snow when that humid air gets cold. I mean, still, it's super tricky to assign any particular weather event to climate change. It's about larger patterns and trends. Which leads us to this question. So I've heard that extreme weather occurrences are more frequent and getting stronger. Is this really true? And what does it have to do with climate change? I'm not convinced. Can someone explain?
We cannot say that all of the extreme events that we are seeing now are a result of climate change. Before even we talk about climate change, we used to have these extremes. But what we are now certain of is that the frequency at which these extremes events occur can easily be linked with climate change. We can be sure that without climate change, some of the extreme events that we are witnessing wouldn't have happened. And in addition to that, for many hazards, there is what we call the attribution study, where scientists try to look at the potential impact that climate change has on these hazards.
In 2021, for example, a group of scientists determined that record-breaking heat waves in parts of the US and Canada would have been virtually impossible without the influence of human-caused climate change. It's like saying that we humans are adding fuel to the fire. Literally. We are. I mean, at least some of us. I recycle. Here's another interesting question. I've heard that the water levels are rising. Is this just because of the ice caps melting? I mean, that's a good one. All I know is that a melting iceberg played a big role in a 3.5-hour movie about a sinking ship and teenagers in love.
I'm the king of the world!
Yeah, but let's see what the experts have to say about it.
Yes, sea levels are rising. And it is a combination of melting ice from both ice caps and glaciers, as well as what's called thermal expansion, which basically means that water that is slightly warmer takes up slightly more volume. So all of the oceans are slightly warmer already. It means they take up more space and therefore the sea level rises a bit.
And that, according to the experts, is one reason why high water levels and surges during big storms keep getting worse. So it's not all about icebergs or teenagers in love. All right, come over here and hold me, Jack.
All right, enough with the Titanic.
No, not enough with the Titanic references. I love that movie, and I will keep milking that bad joke. Coronavirus is damaging people, just like we're damaging the planet. It kind of seems like the Earth is retaliating to its own virus. Us!
Okay, seriously, here's another great question. When storms like this hit, what impact is it having on people and communities who are also dealing with other crises like COVID-19? We're actually getting that question a lot these days.
you're looking at millions. In fact, more than 100 million people have already been hit by weather extremes since the start of the COVID pandemic. The complications, the compound risks, actually come in two ways. The first is that if an extreme hits during COVID, and for instance, we've got restrictions like social distancing, when we need to evacuate people to shelters, or when we need to shelter people after they've been hit by a disaster, that just complicates preparedness and response to those same extremes. So it's harder to deal with the impact. But the second thing may be even more important. It's much more difficult to recover if you, and particularly if you're already poor and struggling to recover from the impact of a natural disaster. For instance, you've been evacuated to a shelter, your life has been saved, but you come home, well, and there is no home anymore. Your home is destroyed, your livelihood is destroyed. How do you pick up your life? Now, if at that same time, it's much more difficult to find a little job, to get a little bit of income, to pick back up after the disaster, you can only imagine that is a double whammy that makes it much harder to recover.
Here's another really interesting question that deals with the combined impact of one crisis on top of another. It has to do with the link between climate change and war. Is climate change causing more conflicts, or is this just a myth?
Well, conflict is a complex issue, and there are a lot of things that contribute to any given conflict, right? So obviously climate change could be one of the contributors in some cases, but what we do know is we don't really see instances where climate is the only thing that causes the conflict. So in some cases, you know, perhaps a drought or perhaps some disagreements over water, for example, could contribute to fueling the fire of a conflict. But I wouldn't say that climate change is causing conflict by itself. Yes, climate can make the impact of conflict worse, because if you're living in a conflict-affected area, for example, maybe you don't have access to health services, you don't maybe have freedom of movement, for example. So if there is an extreme event in your region and you get sick or you need to move out of the way, this can be a big problem. And so people who are living in conflict-affected areas can be particularly affected by climate-related extreme events.
And there we are. I hope you all learned something new today. If you want more content like this, be sure to like the video, subscribe, and hit that bell button below. Are there other climate issues you want to know about? Do you have more questions for our experts? Let us know in the comments below. By the way, I still say it's really freezing in here. See you next time.